Hello friends, my name is Praveen and today I am going to show you how to create a web application using Visual Studio 2022. Visual Studio 2022 is the latest editor from Microsoft. You can find the download links in the description below, and using this Visual Studio 2022 you can do a lot of things. It is a very powerful editor. So in this video I will show you how to create a basic project, and it will be very suitable for the beginners who are new to Microsoft technology and Visual Studio. So this video will be quite useful for them. So let's get started. So here you can see I have opened Visual Studio 2022. Once you download it, just open it and then click on this create a new project. So you'll find a list of these templates. Okay, so there are some filters here, like languages. You can see the languages that is supported by this editor, the platforms, different platforms are there, and then the project types. Okay, so the different project types. So using this different types, you can create different varieties of projects. So if we want to create a web application, then you can see there is this template here, ASP.NET Core Web App. So when you select this template, so by default, it will create some files for you. And then you can run your program, and whatever additional files you want to add, you can add it on your own. But a basic template will be created and presented to you to enhance it further. If you don't find it here, just type the name of the template you are looking for. For example, if I want to find all the web apps, web app templates, then I have typed it. I will type it here like this. And then you can see all the results which are matching web application. And you can see here on the top, it is ASP.NET Core Web App. And this is what I will create now. So let's go ahead and create this project. So select this and click on next button. So here it will ask you what is the name of the project. So give some name. So let's say .NET Core app, and you can give a location. I have a default location, C demo, where I store all my YouTube videos. So you can give any folder name you want here. That is the location where it will be stored, and leave rest as it is and click on next. Here you can see that all the frameworks that are supported by Visual Studio 2022 are provided here. 2.1, 3.1 and 5.0 are out of support, and 2.1 and 5.0 is out of support. 3.1 is long-term support, and 6.0 is long-term support. So I will select .NET 6.0 for this demo. Authentication type, you can select keep it as none, and rest you can leave it as it is, and then click on create. So it'll take a couple of minutes to create the project. You can see this small pop-up here, creating project. So now the project has been created. You can see a solution file. So solution file can contain the project. Okay, like .NET Core app is within your solution file. I will show you how to add multiple projects to the solution file. Let's first start with this project which we have started here, and then you can see there are other things also and in this. But if I click on this project file, so there is a project file here, so under solution file, so you can double click this and you will open it, will open this kind of window here, and here you can see it is .NET 6.0. so this is what the framework, underlying framework, and this is what is supported by this project. Okay, all the class libraries, DLLs, everything is in .NET Core 6.0. There are other settings which you can add manually, like nullable, you can enable or disable it. So implicit usings, you can enable or disable it here. If you disable, for example, the implicit usings, then no need to use usings in your applications, the using keyword which imports the library. So similarly, nullable, if it is disabled, no need for, so it will by default it will not contain null values. So that is what nullable is. Now what we can do is we can go through the pages folder, and here you can see default it has created some HTML files, And then there are some shared files also within the shared folder. Here in the start, you can see that layout is used. So layout is this shared file. So which will contain a basic menu and those things by default, it will be provided. You can edit this and you can enhance this. If I run this, let's run it and see what comes up. Okay, so as you can see, now the browser has opened and the default application has come up here. So if I go to layout page, here I can change few things. For example, the .NET Core app. So this is what is getting displayed here with the anchor tag. You can see there is an anchor, which means it is a link. So I can change this to, let's say, my app. So there is a hot reload feature in Visual Studio 2022, which you can use. So just click on this fire icon here. And what it will do is it will refresh this page. And now you can see the name has changed to my app. Similarly, we can change the, let's change this menu items. I can say this as instead of main home, and then let's call it something like secret. Okay. And click on this hot reload again, go back to the browser, and again the browser is refreshing on its own, and you can see that the menu items have changed. So that is that these are some basic changes which I wanted to show. So let's stop this. Now the browser has closed. I've stopped the application. So there are a few other things you can do. Like if you want to add a project, then you can right click the solution file. One solution can contain many projects, so just click on add new project, and here again search for the type of project you want to add. So let's add a web API project, click on next, and then call it something like a demo API. So the API project I am creating inside this .NET Core app folder. So I'll leave it as it is and then click on create. So now you can see a demo API has been added. So .NET Core app and demo API. So two projects have been added. I can also add, let's say I need a class library project where I can write my business services. So let's add that. So add new project, and then search for this class library. You can type it here as well. So class library project, click on next, and then I can name it my business process. So all my business classes will live here. So click on create, and you can see this project has been added here. So particularly, there'll be two or three more projects in most of the like the corporate standard applications. They will have around five or six projects. So if you are using a database, then there could be a database project or a ORM layer project where you can add your ORMs. So like the class library, you can have one more project where you can add your ORMs, object relational mappers, which will help you to interact with databases like entity framework. So you can add one more project, add entity framework to that project. Similarly, you can add a utility class. For example, there'll be in a, like you'll have log files, or you can have different types of things. So for that, usually what we do is add a class library project and name it like utility and click on next, create. So now a utility project has been added as well. So all these different projects are added to the same solution file. Okay, so your starting point is here, and from this project you can navigate and create objects of other projects within your main project. Okay, similarly you can add different pages. So here Razor is used. You can see this is the Razor format, basically where you have a code behind, and then you have this HTML page or a CHTML page. where you write some HTML code, some logic also, and plus the code behind is where you have the C# code written, so which will handle the events, whatever events happen on the page. So those events can be handled in this page here. So these are the pages. You can, if you want, you can add new pages. For example, add, we can go to Razor page. Okay, select this Razor page. And it will ask you what kind of Razor page you want to, since we are not using entity framework in this example. So I'll just say empty one. Okay, and then give a name to it. So let's give a name like start new. And you can see a start new page has been now added. So this is how you add the pages. You have learned how to add pages. You have seen how to add the projects. Similarly, there are library files also, like Bootstrap library files, jQuery files. So these are supporting files which will help you to create dynamic pages and create pages which you can run across different type of devices. So all these files will help you. Plus you want some styling to be applied to your pages. So those files, a basic file has been provided like site.cs, but you can enhance it. You can add more of your style classes here. And all your, obviously the JavaScript code you can add to this file. Or if you want to add new files also, you can add new JavaScript files here to this folder. So this is where all your supporting libraries, styling files, JavaScript files will live. And pages is where you have your UI and some code behind logic. Then you have this configuration parameters, which can be added to the appsettings.json file. So here you can add your config file, config values, which you want to be configurable. So those kind of things can be added here. Then there are dependencies. So you can see the frameworks which I have added, framework libraries. So if you add more dependencies, you can add. So you can add, like right click, you can see project reference, manage NuGet packages. So this is where you can add external DLLs packages, which is not part of .NET framework, but you need it to run your project. So if you just, you can also add COM references, which are based on the Windows libraries. So those things you can add, you can go to manage NuGet packages. Now all the packages live here. So if you go to browse, you will see a list of NuGet packages which are will help you to create dynamic projects, or you add more capability to your projects. For example, for unit testing, you can add some mocking framework, or for if you want to add some like entity framework you want to use, you can add those libraries, and those libraries will get added here, and then you can interact with those libraries. Using those libraries, you can create you can add new features to your project. So that is about the NuGet packages. So these are things which are provided by default, I thought that I will show you a basic I'll provide a basic tutorial which will be helpful for beginners. So I hope I have covered all these things. If you want to see anything additional and are interested in other videos, please share your comments and subscribe to my channel.